You're also very political in the sense that you write a lot of columns on the Anna movement. You're a huge supporter of it. Thank you so much for that. And you have written, I read your last piece on silly season and the promises of this quota, that quota. This political engagement that you do, will you ever put that in a book? Because your books are about something that is not that heavy.
Yeah.
Is there any reason? Because obviously you feel about it. That's why you write columns about it, because that comes from a position of passion. Why doesn't that come out in the book? Why are books about
college
and
stuff? There is two parts of me. There is an entertainer me and there is a reformer me.
Sure.
You know, these are two passions. Hmm. To change the country. But equally important passion is to just bring the house down. Like, just make everybody laugh. Hmm. And that's my art form, you know, in a way, is the entertainment. So I wanted an outlet.
You have siblings, sorry, just...
Yeah, I have a
Are you the youngest?
Younger.
You have a younger sibling. You're the older one. Okay.
So I have this need, I felt this need to express myself, the reformer me.
Hmm.
That's why I took on the columns. It was an outlet so that I don't make my books too heavy. I don't want to burden the book with everything.
Okay.
So the books also have a reformist streak,
hmm.
but they are largely entertainment. The columns are purely reformist, maybe a little bit entertainment with the odd joke here and there. So these are, for me, I see them as two separate platforms, separate audiences, some overlap, yes, but
you don't see yourself writing a book with...
Maybe, and people are, my publisher was talking about even compiling the columns and doing something. But, you know, I like that I have my space in the columns, which I can comment on something every 2 weeks.
Right.
But for a book, I need a 2-year lead time to get anything.
Okay. Now the Amir Chetan Bhagat battle. Is that all resolved?
Firstly, there was no Amir Chetan Bhagat battle. There was a battle between Chetan Bhagat, it was not even a battle. It was an issue with the makers of Three Idiots.
Which was
Amir Khan was an actor in the movie. Let's, you know, this kind of...
That he made that one statement,
you call
right?
yourself News Laundry, but these are the things I would like to advise you to check against. You know, the first time you said something against Rushdie, I did not.
No, I didn't say against.
Oh, no,
a lot of people are disappointed that he did not support his...
I have supported. I have said that the ban is wrong. Mm-hmm. I have said they should allow it. I have said on Twitter so many times that I have posted passages from the Quran which talks about forgiveness. I don't think anybody else has done that. All that is not, because the stereotype fits that two authors are fighting.
Two binary, yes, no,
yeah.
I like,
and
I don't
even
like.
This, the Amir Khan...
But he did make a statement, I will remind you, because I saw that press conference where he specifically mentioned...
He can mention, but my issue was with the makers.
With the makers, so it wasn't okay, your bad.
The whole country was mentioning things, so he was an actor, so many other actors were there in the movie.
Has that been resolved? Or
of course it's been resolved. Everybody knows that the Three Idiots were adapted from my book, and that was my aim.
Hmm.
So it got resolved by virtue of the controversy itself. There was no settlement required as such,
because the
matter became very clear.
Hmm.
But, you know, it's a sign of changing Bollywood. It's a sign of writers'
demand,
because this routinely happened there. The concept of credit, not just writer, but many other departments, the credits are in the hands of the producer. Whereas, and if the producer likes you a lot, he'll give you a better credit. If he doesn't like you, or, you know, if you have some difference, he will not give you, or if he wants to take it, he can take it. He feels he owns everything. But the copyright law doesn't say allow that. You can own the economics of the film, but you can't take away the credit. You can buy a painting, but you can't say you painted it.
Right.
So that understanding was not there. So that issue, or that controversy, what you want to call it, brought out that understanding, and after that copyright law amendments came. And I think in some ways sometimes it's useful. I don't think it's a controversy as such. It's just a different viewpoint, and it's good to discuss it and resolve and move on, you know.
Okay. Of course, I'm not saying that I think so, but there was that talk of that's a publicity stunt for the filmmakers and they wanted to play
but
it up
at
the time.
It wasn't. It could be. It's a very big issue, you know, when you're talking of plagiarization.
Sure.
It's a very big issue.
Okay.
And neither did that movie need publicity, and neither do I need that kind of publicity. If my credit was proper, the film has been made on my book, it's publicity enough. So it wasn't, but you know, people say all sorts of things.